So thanks again for the announcement, and we are happy to welcome you today and to explain you more about how we boost innovation at PRISMA. This is Mariana.
Hi.
I'm Victoria.
Thank you again for joining us here. We're happy to share with you what we have learned along the way, what have been the cool things and maybe the not so good ones, so you again can learn from them and hopefully implement something of this in your organizations.
And many of you have known PRISMA already, maybe also since a while, and have been following how we have been developing over the past. And key to our success are the people here in PRISMA who are eager to learn, eager to also discover the unknown and stretch their horizon. And in 2019, we started to assemble our very own first IT team here, the internal one, which was so exciting. And what's quite common in bigger tech companies like also Google or Atlassian is that they have a 20-person project in there. So that means you have dedicated time to work on something out of your normal routines. And in Google, for example, they came up with Gmail, which everyone, I think, knows. And I think many of you may have a Google Gmail account. And this is what could happen out of such a dedicated space for everyone to learn and to grow and to experiment.
Yeah, so at PRISMA, we didn't want to be left behind with this trend. And I remember when I first joined the company, I had been here for a couple of months. And our colleague Tom, he first brought this idea of the geek out. For me, it was completely new. I've never heard of this geek out topic. I have never worked in tech before, but I remember there was exciting. The word itself, I was like, okay, there's something here I'm gonna explore. So what it is? So what the geek out was 2 days every 2 months, this time that we had to explore something completely different from our day-to-day work. Yeah, we did different iterations. The first one was about everyone comes with a topic, or everyone who wants can come with a topic. So a small project that we will work over these 2 days. You would say which resources you need, for instance, if you need some special kind of material, and what a kind of colleagues would need to get involved. So if it was a technical project, then of course, probably the developers or the DevOps engineers. And that was also quite nice. Then we tried a different model in which you or we would have to vote. Therefore, everyone would bring their topics, and then you would say, okay, I think this is something I would like to work on, and based on the projects that had the biggest amount of votes, then we would go for this one. And it was quite cool, and actually some pretty nice things came out of it. For instance, during one of these geek outs, Frederick and Tom came together. Frederick, you probably have met before, he's part of our customer success team, and Tom works in QA. So the problem was, or what Frederick's idea was, that we had some kind of a notification system. So whenever we had a number that was not matching to a threshold in the number of auctions, then we would get the notification, or the customer success team would, and we would kind of get an idea that something is possibly happening. So this actually came out of a geek out, which was quite awesome. So the idea, we could see it was working. However, some things started to happen that we wanted to arrange. So for the first thing that we noticed is that people were not participating as much anymore. And we find out that it was because of the topics were getting more and more technical, which meant people like you, Victoria, or myself, who are part of the people and culture team, and we would love to contribute, would not have probably the skills to do it. Again, we're not developers. So then we thought, okay, maybe it's a good opportunity to think outside the box and to find another thing that fits PRISMA better. And that's when we came with the concept of the open space.
So in the year 2020 has been full of changes for all the organizations out there. So this was the year when Corona popped up, and we had to completely change the working mode in all the organizations. Same for us. So people have been working completely remote. There was no chance to meet people, to just have a brainstorming session in the kitchen and to discuss about topics or maybe an issue that you spot the last day. So what we implemented here in PRISMA, and maybe you have seen it while following us when you arrived this morning into the office, maybe you have seen the three hearts somewhere, the three red hearts. So we call it the heartbeat here in PRISMA. And this is the rhythm the whole organization is following. And we start on Monday mornings at 10 a.m., like today, with the all-hands meeting, where it's about the whole organization coming together and creating regular touch points with every PRISMate. The audience is all about company updates and sharing what's most important for everyone. And then it's followed by the open space. It's the Tuesday. And with the open space, it's a concept that we don't invent it, but it was something from the, I think, the middle of the 80s. So it's a proven concept that we thought, okay, let's try it out and let's make sure that everyone feels, again, integrated, connected, and has something to contribute on those 2 days. And it's spontaneously what the people come up with. It can be a workshop. It can be a teaching session. It can also be maybe a case study that you will present. So it's open to everything which you may need on those days, and we do it now on a regular basis every 2 weeks.
Yep. So what the concept looks like. So you might have been also wondering, what is this really cool setup that we organize for you guys here? So this is how we would represent our open space here at PRISMA. So as Victoria said, we would have this every 2 weeks on Tuesdays at 10 a.m. We would start in here, what this would be our kitchen before Corona, of course. We would all get together and we would have two moderators who would ask everyone in the audience who want to pitch a topic to please come on front and tell us about what they would like to explore during this open space. And I remember, Victoria, you actually had a topic quite recently.
Yeah. So last year in summer, I attended an online workshop about liberating structures. You will learn about many, many different methods on how to involve the full audience and many people in an in-personal setting or also in a hybrid working mode. So I also came to the fund, pitched the topic, and invited the people whoever is interested in the topic to join me the first session slot then at 10 and join me in the room with the nice yellow car here.
And just like Victoria did, whoever wanted to share could come up the front. That was the case for me as well. So for me, I didn't want to present something that I've learned, but I wanted to ask for feedback from our colleagues. So I wanted to learn about how their onboarding experience had worked. So I came to the front and I pitched. So I want some feedback from you guys. It would take 1 hour, 15 minutes, and I would do it in the Tiger Room. It's important to note that we had 3 different sessions going from 45 minutes, 1 hour to 1 hour, 15. So depending on the needs of your topic, you can choose whatever fits better. Then you choose the room and then your colleagues can join. Some sessions are happening at the same time. Some happen after one after the other. And something that was quite nice, of course, also before Corona times, was that we had a common lunch. So the company would sponsor this and we would all get together and also continue to just collaborate during enjoying a really, really nice food. So yeah, after we pitch the topics and we know what is happening where, we would move to different rooms. Another important thing to mention is that the open space is not only about giving, it can also be about receiving. For instance, in this case, we have Mike, who you probably already met from another session before us. So in this case, Mike, he's a backend developer and he wanted to learn about front end. So what he said is, hey guys, I would love if someone would take the time to explain me what JavaScript is. And in this case, Philip, he said, hey Mike, I'm happy to do so. So let's all meet in the jungle room. I would need 45 minutes for this, and whoever is interested in JavaScript can join us there. So everyone would start moving around to the sessions they want to join. There might also be some people who said, you know what, I also have a project, but I want to do it independently, so by myself, and this can also happen. And on the other hand, we can have some colleagues who said, you know what, today's topics maybe are not for me, I will do it in 2 weeks, and I'll just go back to my regular day. Someone back.
And to make this a successful day, there are some principles that we are also following. So whoever comes to the session you are offering is the right people. That means those people are really attracted by the topic that you brought up, and they are the best people to contribute. And whatever happens in the session is the only thing that could happen, because we all think that the people will come, be focused, and do their best to make this a successful round on that day. And also creativity needs to flow, so please don't pay attention to a clock. So whenever you start, it's the right moment, and whenever it's over, that's the only thing that could happen. And there's the rule of 2 feet. So I also once had a moment when I was interested in not just one but 2 sessions at the same time. So there's also the option to just move from one session to the other whenever you feel you want to.
So you kind of get the best of both worlds. You can participate in as many sessions as you want because there are no hard feelings based on this principle. So you can just float around whenever you feel that you have gathered all the information you want, or simply because you want to explore and just move around. So during this time, we have been working with the open space for some months now, and we have collected, of course, feedback. And what we have heard is that people are really enjoying this new concept. They especially like that we don't have to wait 2 months in order to work in this. So we have shorter periods, just 2 weeks. There's a diversity of topics, so not only tech, but as you can see from this example, a lot of things can come out of it. You can also get feedback in a personal way without having to go for the traditional survey. And of course, it's also a safe space to practice maybe some other skills, like conducting a workshop, which could be a bit nerve-wracking if you don't have this, safe space to do it with your colleagues and so on.
So what's now the recipe of boosting innovation here in PRISMA? It's to make sure that you can involve all the PRISMates on the same spot. It's about the combination of learning and collaboration. It's about having a lot of people here who really want to strengthen their horizon. And it's about ensuring there's open communication across all the different levels, across all the different teams, which then also lowers the barriers of asking questions. And those on a continuous basis is the recipe for us to boost innovation.
So as mentioned in the beginning, we hope that you find this small session inspiring and that you try this at your organizations. And of course, Victoria and I are here directly to answer any questions you might have. So thank you for taking the time today.
Thank you.